In this video, I will give you an overview of Radio Planner 2.1, our software for wireless network planning. For more details, refer to the user guide on our website, www.wireless-planning.com. Radio Planner 2.1 is a tool for planning GSM 3G LTE networks, P25, Tetra, DMR, and other land mobile radio networks, networks based on wireless Internet of Things technologies, for example, LoRa and similar, as well as terrestrial radio and television broadcast networks, for example, DVB-T2, DAB, DAB+, and similar. Radio Planner 2.1 has two different types of project: mobile radio communication and radio TV broadcasting. The configuration of the program menu and the set of input parameters depend on the project type. So before starting, the user has to select the project type in the settings menu. Radio Planner 2.1 uses two types of geodata: digital train model, SRTM3 dataset, and land cover model with different types of clutter: dense urban, urban, suburban, open land, water, and trees or forest. Land cover model was created on the basis of OpenStreetMap. All geodata is downloaded automatically as needed. There is no need to worry about preloading the geodata. In addition, the software allows using various types of base maps, common such as OpenStreetMap, OpenTopoMap, etc., and custom ones. There are several examples of projects for various wireless and broadcast networks in the software package. In our case, it is P25 LAN Mobile Radio Project. Radio Planner 2.1 uses Tree View interface as the main user menu. It is located on the left side of the main panel. When you select one of the menu items, the panel corresponding to the item emerges next to it. Radio Planner 2.1 performs various types of area studies for mobile networks. Received power uplink downlink maps show those areas where a given signal level is present at the receiver. From mobile unit number 1, portable radio, you can set one from 8 different levels of received signal, which simulate different reception conditions, for example, on the street, inside the car, indoors, etc., or different data transfer rates. For mobile unit number 2, it is a mobile radio with its antenna on the car's roof, only one signal level can be set. You can also take into account interference on the co-channel and adjacent channels. There are two correspondent checkboxes in the bottom of the panel. If the interference on the co-channel and adjacent channels exceeds the allowable level at a particular point, this point will be excluded from the coverage area. You can also choose the area study resolution. The higher the resolution, the longer the calculation time. The strongest server map is a map showing the identity of the sector supplying the strongest received signal at each queried location. Sector colors can be assigned automatically or in accordance with the table of frequency groups. The carrier to interference ratio, CI, is one of the most important parameters used to assess the system performance that can affect frequency planning. Radio Planner allows you to calculate and display areas with different CI values for the interference on co-channel and adjacent channels at the input of a mobile unit receiver. Area with signal above both the base and mobile thresholds. This area study type displays a map showing those grid locations where both the signal received by the mobile or remote unit is above the remote receiver threshold, and from where the signal received by the base station from the mobile or remote is above the base threshold. The calculation result of any type of coverage can be saved as an image file or an interactive web page. When you save the coverage as an image, the maximum size of the bitmap image is approximately 5400 by 4400 pixels. The file size in the PNG format is about 10 megabytes. When you save the coverage is a web page, the application offers the user to select the location and the name of the directory in which the result is saved. To open a web page, just open the index.html file in the browser. This web page allows you to choose a base map from 4 different base maps, change zoom, view basic data from the legend, as well as display the scale and current coordinates of the cursor. In the Map Layers menu, the user can control layers that are displayed on the map. The order of the layers in the menu corresponds to the order in the map. The base map is below all the layers, sides are on top. The user can load and display any point or linear vector object in KML format as a layer in the map. This may be, for example, power lines or pipelines. This can also be results of measurements of signal levels for comparison with calculated values and adjustment of propagation model parameters. Point objects can also be downloaded from a CSV file, text format where the separator is a semicolon. Coverage is the control layer with the result of radio coverage calculation. Control the length of a layer. User can show or hide layers as well as change their transparency and other properties. All calculations are performed in accordance with the recommendation ITU RP 18.12.4 or a path-specific propagation prediction method for point-to-area terrestrial services in the VHF and UHF bands. The following main factors which affect propagation are taken into account: diffraction loss on the path profile obtained from the SRTM data, the influence of local surrounding objects that exist in the land cover model, temporal and spatial instability of the received radio signal, slow and fast fading. Radio Planner calculates the signal power loss on local obstacles surrounding the mobile unit using the land cover model with the different types of clutter: dense urban, urban, suburban, open land, water, and trees or forest. To determine the loss according to aforementioned recommendation, user should select Calculate the loss in recommendation ITU RP 18.12.4 and specify in the table the average height of the obstacles of each type based on local conditions. The user can also set clutter loss manually for each type of obstacles based on their own data. To do this, simply enter the losses in the table. In the Mobile Units menu, the user sets the parameters of the mobile units. The application allows calculating radio coverage for the two type of mobile units. For example, in professional wireless networks, portable and mobile subscriber stations are often used, which differ in both energy characteristics and antenna height relative to the ground level. In the base station network menu, the user sets the parameters of the wireless network, base stations, and their sectors. Using the toolbar here, you can create a new base station from one of the templates, import sites from CSV file, sort base stations in alphabetical order, or delete all active base stations. Using the toolbar in the base station details, you can create a new base station as a copy of the given base station, move the given base station up or down, delete the base station, load the base station parameters from a template, save the parameters of the base station, including the parameters of all its sectors, as a template, position the map with the base station at the center of the screen. Using the toolbar in the sector parameters, you can create a new sector as a copy of the given sector, move the sector up and down, delete the sector, or change the group of active sector parameters based on the current sector parameters, as well as position the map with the base station at the center of the screen. You can set all the parameters such as channel group, TX, RX, cable and antenna parameters. Global active sector parameters changed based on the parameters of the current sector and is a useful feature that allows you to instantly change the parameters of any sector in accordance with the parameters of the current sector. When you right-click on the base map, the context menu appears and you can create a new base station at the given point, change the location of the current or selected base station, open the parameters of the nearest base station or focus on it. In the report menu, you can create several types of equipment text report: short, complete, for all, or only for active base stations. Using the toolbar, which is located above the report, you can set it to print, as well as save it in PDF, Microsoft Word, or Excel formats. In Point Calculations menu, the user can see the detailed results of the received signal power calculations in the down and up directions at any point, as well as the levels of interference on the co-channel and adjacent channels. You can change the current point on the map by clicking the mouse in the place you want. The path profile shows the heights of the antenna radiation center of the selected BS sector and the subscriber station, as well as the Fresnel zone for the radio beam, the loss in free space, the diffraction loss due to the terrain, and the obstacles surrounding the mobile unit. The colors that mark the various obstacles on the profile correspond to the colors of the land cover model. Radio Planner allows frequency planning in consideration with the co-channel and adjacent channels interference. In the Channel Plan menu, you can set frequencies for frequency groups. In addition, the following system parameters are set here that affect the interference: channel bandwidth, minimum working co-channel carrier to interference ratio, minimum working co-channel carrier to adjacent channel ratio. Some utilities that help in the work are built into the radio planner. The tool ruler allows measuring the distance and azimuth between any two points. To perform a measurement, click on the ruler, then click on any two points of the map and you will see the distance between the two points and the azimuth from the first to the second. To exit, right-click anywhere on the map. The calculator built into the software allows you to determine the receiver sensitivity limited by man-made noise for various environmental conditions and frequencies in accordance with recommendation ITURP 37213, radio noise, as well as studies commissioned by the British governmental agency Ofcom. Radio and TV broadcast. Radio Planner 2.1 allows you to perform calculations of the coverage for the transmitters of television and radio broadcast, as well as automatically determine the population in the coverage area based on the OpenStreetMap project base. Based on the results of the calculation, a list of localities covered by the broadcasting is formed, indicating the population in each locality and the total population in the coverage area.